Ladies and gentlemen, you are now entering the Decent Christian Talk podcast. Enjoy.
Decent Christian Talk, episode number 52. I'm Gabe Jones. This is a podcast by the fans and for the fans, and this week is no different. We've got a great episode for you this week. We've got Mr. Anthony Armstrong from the rock and roll band Red. They just released a new record in late October called Gone. It is their sixth studio record. It's a really great album. I've gotten a chance to listen to it. But we got a conversation with him coming up later in the show. You don't want to miss that. We also got a great flashback for you this week. You don't want to miss that either. Before we head into any of that, we need to talk about our Patreon page. Hey guys, unfortunately, when it comes to podcasts and any kind of online work, things cost money. There's costs to running these types of things. And our Patreon page is a way for you guys to support us, partner with us, join our team. It's an easy way to do that. You can do that for as low as a dollar a month. You can go to patreon.com/decentchristiantalk. That's Patreon, patreon.com/decentchristiantalk. And you can join our team and help support us. It costs just a little bit to run these kinds of things and just keep some of our things updated and up to speed online. And, you know, you guys have helped out so far along the way, and we just continue to appreciate your support. That's patreon.com/decentchristiantalk, and you can join our team. You can also go to decentchristiantalk.com on your laptop. Check out the right-hand side of the page. There's a donate button on there if you want to do a one-time gift. We would definitely appreciate that. That would help our podcast keep running the way it is and continue to grow as it has been. We just thank you guys so much for joining us each and every single week. We've got a great episode for you. As I mentioned before, we have Anthony Armstrong from Red coming up later in the show. But before we head into that, flashback, the Decent Christian Talk flashback is back this week, and it is going to be about Red's debut album. We're going to talk about Red's recent release called Gone later on in the show with Anthony. But before we head into that, we're going to go back and look at their debut album called End of Silence. It's a really good album. It was a great debut from Red. It's one of the historically great debuts of any band in Christian music. We're just going to head right into that right now. Check it out.
The Decent Christian Talk Podcast Flashback.
In the early 2000s, Anthony and Randy Armstrong, along with Michael Barnes, formed Red. The trio grew up in the Erie, Pennsylvania area. The band became inspired by attending different festivals, such as the Creation Festival. After completing their education, the band moved to Nashville. The band worked on putting together a first record while working full-time jobs. During this time, the band rounded out their lineup, which included now Breaking Bad guitarist Jason Roach. While working on their first record, the band signed with Essential Records. Finally, after spending 2 years on the record, the band released End of Silence on June 6, 2006. The record saw considerable airplay on Christian and mainstream radio. This included songs such as Break Me Down, Pieces, Let Go, Already Over, and breathe into me. Breathe Into Me won the Dove Award for Best Recorded Song of the Year in 2007. Also in 2007, the album was nominated for a Grammy for Best Rock Gospel Album. Lost also won the Dove Award for Best Recorded Rock Song in 2009. The album was certified gold in 2015 for selling over 500,000 copies. Following the release of End of Silence, the band toured with mainstream acts such as Breaking Benjamin, 3 Days Grace, and Candlebox. In 2016, the band released a special 10th anniversary deluxe edition of End of Silence, which included some acoustic remixes of some songs. The band also had a special 10th anniversary End of Silence tour, which spanned from 2016 to 2017. While Red has endured a few lineup changes over the years, the band still includes the original trio of Anthony and Randy Armstrong and Michael Barnes. Since the band's debut, End of Silence, the band has released 5 more full-length records, including Gone, which recently released in October 2017. That was our Decent Christian Talk flashback, Red's End of Silence, one of my favorite albums of all time, to be honest with you. It's hard to believe it's already been over 10 years since that record came out. I just remembered a lot of the mainstream play that album got, and it was a little surprising for a band that was just getting started out. Red wasn't a band like 21 Pilots or one of those bands that has Christians in it, but they're not really a Christian band. Red's never really shied away from that, and so it was really cool to see them have that success early on. It kind of goes down in history along with, like, Jars of Clay and Third Day and a lot of great bands that kind of started out with a bang on their debut album. Small Town Poets is one that comes to mind. Some would say that their debut album was their best album. I mean, that's kind of up for debate. But it was just really cool to see them start out the way they did and, just continue to rock ever since. Some bands have progressively changed over the years. And I don't think Red is one of those that's necessarily changed that much. They have a sound that is pretty identifiable, and it's pretty cool to hear. Just kind of their longevity is kind of a testament to their sound and kind of their will to continue to succeed as a band. And that album, man, I there's a lot of songs on that I can remember listening to. I listened to the crap out of that album. Just a lot of those songs over and over and over again mean a lot to me, and it's cool to go back and listen to that album doing the flashback, and I'd encourage you guys to go and listen to that album. Another album you need to check out is their recent release called Gone. It is their 6th studio release, as we mentioned in the flashback. It's a really good album. I've got to listen to it over the last couple of weeks. And I think it's probably their strongest album, maybe since their second album. And I really dug this album. There's a lot of cool singles on this album that are really going to make a lot of heads turn when it comes to radio play. Still Alive is already on the radio and it's doing well. I would encourage you guys to listen to that. And while you are at it, why don't you check out our interview with Anthony Armstrong. Anthony, as some of you may know, Red has a set of twins in the band, and Anthony Armstrong is one of the twins, and my brothers actually got to catch up with him recently. Josiah and Nathaniel did a great job talking to him, and we're just going to play that interview for you right now. Hit it.
All right, hit that horn, babe. Let's dance.
Hey, this is Josiah. That's my brother Nathaniel. So we're brothers as well, and I know you have a brother in the band. You guys just released your sixth album, Gone. Tell us a little bit about that.
I just came out on the 27th. It took about a year and a half, almost 2 years to make. So I don't know what do you want to hear.
Well, maybe some of the themes. What's different about this album than maybe some of your past albums?
I think the themes kind of right down the middle of it is just where we stand, just in our life and how we're gonna be remembered. Everything that's going on out there in the world and the killings and the suicides and all the stuff that's happening that you see in the media, you know, it feels like life is even more precious than ever before, based on the terror and the fear and the things that are happening to people just all across our country and around the world that just, you know, unexpectedly happen and life is taken. And just a deeper look at, you know, what it is we're going to do with the time we have, you know, whether it's, you know, something happens and that light, or if it's something that happens naturally to us in our lives, that, you know, where we're going to be in people's hearts and minds when we're gone.
Yeah, I've been listening to the album since it came out, and it does seem a very reflective kind of, you guys have been around for a while. The thought crossed my mind was this, going into this album, did you guys even contemplate maybe, is this it? Is this the last album, or should we even do another album? Was that in your minds?
Every single record is like that. So it's nothing different. I mean, after the second record, the first record, we were guaranteed a record. So after that, everything from that point on was never guaranteed. So it's a deeper look at that, you know, just kind of in light of what's been happening. Like I said, you know, we don't ever expect to be able to make another record. You know, we want to, obviously our wants, you know, heavily outweigh what the plan actually ends up being. So, you know, just we've been blessed and been able to do that, you know, over and over again, and it's been nice. But, you know, technically speaking, this is the last record on our record deal. So we're not quite sure where we go from here, if we hang it up, if we continue to tour, if, you know, there's a lot of questions circling around. So.
Yeah, well, hopefully this isn't the last album for a fan of like myself. I noticed that throughout your guys' entire career, you never shy away from the real issues, things such as mental health or things that are happening in the news or anything like that. What are some of the fan responses that you get from attacking these real issues?
A lot of it's positive. I mean, a lot of kids want to see, you know, a band of, you know, of just a, we're just a rock band, but we're a group of Christian guys and believers. And I think, you know, a lot of times, you know, with that side of music, with the GMA, it's tough for that. A lot of artists to dive into, you know, difficult subjects. And I, you know, a lot of them do it and do it really well. But I think Red goes a little bit further and, kind of it exploits what, you know, the dirty side of life and how life is really lived by all of us, and you know, the things that we get into and the vices that we create for ourselves, and And we just like to talk about those things because that's real. You know, we don't like putting on a facade. You know, now there's a song on the record called "The Mask Slips Away." And that's what it's about. It's, you know, there's no covering up who we are, you know, as people and individuals in this group. And you know, we're using, you know, that's all we do really with our music, is talk about where our faith has led us and how our faith has gotten us through. And it's just this record is just another extension of that.
I know, just from listening to your music, there's always a song on the album that just kind of jumps out and hits me. Probably Pieces was the song that came to me in a lifetime in my life when I was in pieces. So Red always has a special place in my heart for just attacking some of the real issues, such as mental health and things like that, that has been brought to light recently with some of the things in the news, like lead singer from Linkin Park and things like that. Did that affect you guys in any way? Did you go on tour with them, or do you know them at all?
Yeah, absolutely. Because, you know, Chester was a huge blow to our band. It's just as he was to so many music lovers and artists and fellow peers, and just to see someone, you know, take their life, you know, it's just to be out of the blue. You know, I got a text message from a friend when it was literally not even being reported yet that he found out that he had committed suicide, and it was like, no, that's not true. There's no way. And I started looking around, and I didn't see anything from the other artists, you know, other band members in the group, and didn't see any of those reports. And then all of a sudden, within an hour, it just exploded all over social media, and our jaws were on the floor. You know, it's just like, this guy was a huge inspiration to us, and, you know, just loved what they've done musically, but to find out that just all these deep, dark seated issues that this guy was really struggling with, he just felt like he couldn't do it anymore. And the song on our record that's actually our first single is that's exactly what it's for. It's, you know, it's a song called "Still Alive." It's about, you know, it's, people feel like life is meaningless. You know, why are we even here? What is this all really for?
Yeah.
And you ask yourself that seriously. Why are we walking this earth? What's our whole point of being here? You know, but regardless of what that point is, of, you know, we all are obviously guys, men of faith, and believe in something, you know, higher, and that creation is a real thing, and all, you know, everything that comes along with that. But it's just, you know, still, we're still human, and still our brains are still very small and work like a human brain, and it gets down to that basic, you know, instinctual question of why, you know, but if you're, you know, you're obviously stuck inside that, you know, not understanding, it's a scary place to be. And it's kind of like, you know, you could maybe contemplate and ask that question, but, you know, regardless of all the pain and agony and things that everybody goes through, the depression and, you know, we're still here, we're still alive, we're still pushing through regardless, and because we know that, you know, there's something better on the other side of all of it. So it's...
What are some of the
reactions? Supposed to be an uplifting, empowering song.
Yeah. What,
say that again?
What are some of the reactions backstage? You often go on tour with bands that aren't Christian. Do they come to you with... I mean, just like fans, do they come to you and say, wow, that song, that meant something to me? What do you get?
Yeah, of course. Yeah. At the end of the day, yeah, we're, you know, a group of guys that are Christian guys, but our band is just a band. And we don't ever like calling our band a Christian band. You know, it's tough, but people know and who we are and the way we like to carry ourselves and how we define ourselves as men. You know, as believers, you know, it's obviously, you know, interesting and peculiar to people, and they, you know, especially with fans, obviously they ask us all the time, you know, and we don't really like defining our songs for people. We don't like telling them, you know, well, this is why we wrote it, because it automatically changes, you know, a perspective that's pretty delicate for fans. You know, it's like, well, I heard, this is what it made me think of, and this is, you know, it could be a completely different thing than what we're actually writing. The song and what it was in, you know, at the time, what was in our heads. So we don't ever want to take that away from listeners. And it's that's what music, that's the beauty of music. You know, they get a chance to hear it and, and they just absorb it the way they want to.
Yeah. No, absolutely. I agree with that, because, like you said, if you have an idea in your head and then you figure out something else, it's just like watching a TV show and then finding out behind the scenes that they meant something else.
Exactly.
Like you said, this album is a lot about legacy. You guys just came off of your 10-year anniversary for the End of Silence tour. Go into that just a little bit. Was when you guys put that album out, it was the biggest thing on any radio. Did you guys think, wow, this is easy?
It was an interesting tour. It was, you know, it's like, wow, it's been 10 years. It felt like it was, you know, 10 days ago. You know, it's all been kind of a blur, you know, not a bad blur as in, we don't remember any of it. No, I mean, like, it's just been such a crazy ride, and just, we've seen and experienced so many things with the music we've been able to, you know, been able to make. It's just so cool. We had a lot of fans that came out, you know, wearing t-shirts that they bought at one of our very first tours, you know, just in response to it being a 10-year anniversary type thing. And it's just so cool, you know, the support that we got, and the, you know, just through the years, all the stories we've heard of people and how the music has just helped them so much. And it's all the music's done for them is the same thing it did for us writing it. You know, that's the reason we wanted to make music. We wanted to write about, you know, it's like we, you know, the End of Silence was the title of that record for a reason. You know, there's a lot of, you know, artists out there that are afraid to talk about, you know, cause there's a, you know, there's a set of rules that, you know, certain believers have to live by, and you can't talk about this, and you can't say this, and you can't say that, and you can't do this, and you can't do that. It just seems like it's always all the rules just, you know, cloud the real issues and cloud the real, you know, reason, what, you know, the real idea behind being a believer. And I think Red's just always tried to stomp on the throat of that whole ideology and push through, you know, and you know, change people's hearts and open their minds, you know. And it's been an amazing experience. You know, there's still people that don't understand and don't like what we do, and that's okay. You know, we're not gonna impact everybody. I wish we could, but you know, I think a lot of that is also based on fear. A lot of people, you know, they see us and they're like, oh, these guys are scary, you know. You know, our Winter Jam performance last year was pretty intense, and we got a lot of hate mail from believers, and that was hard to see, you know, from fellow believers, that they were, you know, bashing us for doing what we were doing, and it was tough.
We were just talking about kind of the journey that Red has taken, and it's been a journey that you've taken with your brother the entire time. How's that been for you?
I've actually loved it. It's been really cool to have. I don't know, it's sometimes it's hard with family to be professional, you know, and have a professional, you know, business and be professionals together, because you know, family can cloud so many things when it comes to that stuff. And it's been cool. It's been really cool. We've had our family, you know, back and forth type moments, but it's, you know, it's, for the most part, it's been very fulfilling. And you know, we've been doing this since we were 16 years old together. So we're pretty good at it.
Yeah. Is it fun to interact on stage with each other? Just looking around, and like, especially on the End of Silence tour, the first time you guys started touring together, and just seeing the reaction from fans, how well the album did, and then just getting to share that moment with each other. How was that?
It's pretty cool. You know, any young artist that gets the opportunity to have a platform like we've had, and, you know, major label and all these other, you know, huge, cool, fun things that, you know, you really kind of need to make it, you know. You just need to see that it had a foothold, you know, pretty much from the very beginning. You know, you never expect that to happen, but yeah. I guess the world was just ready for what we had to offer. And it's a lot of timing, you know, and we didn't set out knowing that was going to happen, but it started too quickly, and you know, that's why we're still here, I believe, now. It's because of the initial
One of the things that we get to enjoy as family every year is we go to Creation Festival, and we probably pushed around in the mosh pit with you guys a few times without even realizing it, but That's one thing that I've always heard you talk about in concert, that you used to be a fan down in the sweaty pit, just like the rest of us. What's that like to see coming full circle and being a part of the 40-year history
now be the band.
Of Creation?
Yeah, we went to Creation every single year all the way through high school until we were seniors. When we were juniors, we started making music, and it was even more, you know, it was funny. We went from being, you know, the little youth group nerds to being the music guys that are like, really paying attention to what the artists are doing on stage, you know, not so much just jumping around being, you know, crazy people, but more so like, oh man. So I wonder if we ever got a chance to do this. We do, you know, your gears are turning, you know.
Yeah.
You're seeing what's happening.
If you could go back and meet yourself at Creation Festival when you were 16 years old, what would you tell yourself before this journey that you've been on with Red?
That's hard to say. It's I think we'd be just kicking ourselves like, this is actually happening. You know, it's you're a needle in a stack of needles in the music industry, and I don't think people realize that until they actually try to dive into it and do it. I think there's a lot of industries that are like that. Period. You know, even film with acting. You know, all this. There's so many different careers that are just they're a shot in the dark. You know, it's and. You know, for us to have had the success that we've had is just, you know, when I was 60 years old, I would have known that I was, you know, riding on a tour bus, driving down the road right now. You know, it's, yeah. It doesn't compute a lot of times. You kind of just have to leave it alone, because your brain will explode, you know?
Yeah. Well, you guys are traveling right now. I looked it up. I think your first show is tomorrow. Is that right?
It's in Lexington, yeah. Lexington, Kentucky.
Where can we find some information about that tour, if it's coming near us or anything like that?
Yeah, our website is the best place. Usually is redmusiconline.com. And then from there, there's links to all of our Instagrams and our Twitters and stuff that people can talk to us. And we run all of our virals ourselves. So when fans write to us and message us, that's you're talking to the guy, not some person at a label with a computer in front of them. So.
That was our interview with Anthony Armstrong of Red. Just really like to thank Anthony for taking the time out. They were actually on tour when that interview happened, in the middle of touring, and you know, that's just a really busy time for a band, especially right after an album release. So I'd really like to thank him for taking the time out to talk with us. Thank you to my brothers Josiah and Nathaniel for doing that awesome interview. It's always good to hear them talk with bands that they enjoy. And hey guys, we are a podcast that's by the fans for the fans. We're not a bunch of insiders, music insiders. We don't live in Nashville. We're not a group of guys that are in the industry. We're just fans, and we just really enjoy doing this podcast for you guys. And we've been running this show for over a year and a half now. We've had our website for over 3 years now, and we're just going to continue to rock as long as we can. Hey guys, thank you so much for checking us out. It's hard to believe Thanksgiving's coming up soon. The end of the year is almost here. So we're going to be winding down this podcast for a few weeks to take a break for the holidays. Don't forget to check out our podcast coming up. Keep on listening, because we do have a new podcast that's going to be added to our network in 2018. It's not really a podcast that is going to be related to music. It's going to be more of a kind of a practical podcast dealing with family and adoption and fostering, and it's just going to be a really cool conversational podcast. It's not going to be with me. It's going to be with some people that we know and people that we believe in, and to be honest with you, they are family, so it's going to be fun to see that. But be checking out, be looking out for that announcement coming soon. We are looking forward to that. Hey guys, check us out at DecentChristianTalk.com. That's our website. We're going to be posting all the podcasts from this, the Decent Christian Talk show, And this new show, it's all going to be posted on there. So you want to go on there. There's a place where you can put your email address. That way, every time we post something, you get a notification in your email box, and that's completely free. While you're there, you can, of course, like we mentioned before, you can give us a nice donation. The holidays are here. If you want to give us a buck or two, that would really be awesome. That would help cover some of the costs that we have for this show. We are on Twitter, DC Talk Act 2. We are on Instagram, the DC Talk Podcast, just DC Talk Podcast, not the DC Talk Podcast. We are also on Snapchat, DCT Podcast. And of course, we are on Facebook, the Decent Christian Talk page, and then there's a Decent Christian Talk Podcast conversational page. We're just going to continue to be putting out stuff. Maybe a show or two for the rest of the year. Like I said, we are going to be taking a little bit of a break at the end of the year. We are going to be heading to Kevin Max's Winterwood show at the beginning of December. We really like to talk and meet some of you guys there. That's in less than a month, so if you guys are headed there, make sure you look out for us. We're going to be around. We're going to be hanging out. We're looking forward to hanging out with Kevin as well and some of his band. Maybe even doing a show or two down there. Maybe we'll do a live podcast with some fans and just kind of have a nice little round table. Who knows? We'll see. See if that's even something that you guys would want to do. But hey, that's about all for this show this week. We'd just really, again, like to thank Anthony Armstrong for joining us this week. We will catch you next time. Peace.
Don't forget to tip your waiters and waitresses. Thanks.